know that if you twist an ankle, you will be left behind.
Okay. Good morning, everyone. Family does not approve of my outfit choice today because apparently my itinerary to my outfit was a little bit off. But let me just say, the outfit is absolutely giving and it's gonna look really good. But apparently we're like hiking. You only go to Europe once. So if that means you're hiking ruins in this outfit, then so be it. Good morning. Welcome back to another vlog. Today we are in Portugal. Apparently we're going to see a castle and apparently we're hiking ruins and seeing gardens. See, I thought we were just gonna be meandering around some gardens. So let me give you an outfit check for the day and then we are headed out to the train. It's the little outfit today and the dress. I'm literally obsessed with all the colors and the length is perfect. Apparently, my shoes are my family's biggest problem today. They're like an inch. That's like an inch. That's literally an inch. If I can go to the Daytona 500 and walk 33,000 steps in 7-inch heels, I think I can make it through this, but I guess I'll report back. And I already have my preemptive blister band-aids on. Walk a mile in these Louis Vuittons. We're gonna be fine.
Mom is currently manifesting that I break my ankle because I just received this key in case we split up for any reason.
We're off running.
Colors, we're matching.
We are at the train station and we are currently in Lisbon, so we're gonna be taking a train. It's about a 50-minute ride to Sintra. Just got off the train. It took about 50 minutes and now we are in Sintra, but it's raining. I did pack an umbrella. Everyone talks about the hills in Portugal, but no one talks about how slippery the hills are in Portugal because they're just made of these little smooth little cobblestones and they are literally so slippery. Oh my God, we just discovered.
That's the one
we're going
bus to, right?
All the way up there. I have no regrets. We made it to the top, well, like halfway, not to the top, but we made it and we are currently at the Quinta de Regalaria, and it has little gardens and secret caves and stuff, but I'll show you everything. Checked out that little castle area and now we're gonna head to lunch. I honestly feel like all we've done on this trip is walk and then eat and then walk and then eat, but all of the food has been so good. I'll show you everything we get for lunch.
So for lunch we are eating at Beco de Sintra. Thank you.
Dallas. We finished lunch and it was so good. I think that the ceviche was everyone's favorite, but if you are in Sintra, you guys should check it out because it's tucked away. We were actually the only people in there, but the food was 10 out of 10. We just finished up at Peña Palace and now we're walking back down that massive hill that we walked up. Let me just say, walking downhill in heels is a lot harder than walking uphill, but we're walking past these lakes right now and these are the exact lakes that I would picture Taylor Swift singing about in her song The Lake. So let me show you.
Take me to the lakes where all the poets went to die. I don't belong, my beloved, neither do you. Those Windermere peaks look like a perfect place to cry. I'm setting up, but not without my muse. No, not without you.
So we just took the train back from Sintra and we are in Lisbon now and we had to go to the McDonald's to use the bathroom. So we just bought a water to get the code to the bathroom. But now we're just kind of walking around Lisbon's like central square. This is what it looks like right now. So I think we're gonna try to just find some cute little stores to pop in and maybe grab like a little bite of food, but nothing crazy. And we also don't have anything like super structured planned for the rest of the day, which is really nice because we can kind of explore. But I will show you what all we get into.
We found a little gelato place and I got the Oreo gelato and then we also got the mango gelato. Cheers! Thank you!
Pregos from the same market that we went to that first night. Last time we got the Bifana and this is a Prego. It's like cooked in like garlic and other different flavors and it's very good.
So we just got back to the Airbnb and I actually laid down for like 2 minutes. I am so exhausted. We walked 21,000 steps today, according to my phone, which is a lot. So I'm going to shower and get ready for bed. It is currently 9:45 p.m. and we've been going since 8 a.m. So I am ready. I'm ready to call it a day, but today was so much fun. I loved going to the castles and seeing the lakes and all of that good stuff. And it's also just fun to be able to walk everywhere. Like I feel like in the United States, like it's, you can't really just like walk around every single place and have it be like super safe and super beautiful. The architecture here is just stunning and all the views everywhere are stunning. Also, public transportation, you guys saw we were on a bus and then we're on a train and then we're on another bus. It's like, it's so easy here. I'm like, is it that hard? Is it so hard to get
a train in Florida to take me to Miami. Because I don't think it is. But I am gonna shower and go to bed because I am actually physically exhausted. I think I'm gonna sleep with like my feet elevated, just to, like, get the pressure off of my ankles. I don't remember the last time that I walked 21,000 steps in a day. And now it's time for me to go to bed. And I love you guys. Thanks for joining me for another day in Portugal.